ate and died. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم ate from it, stopped, did not continue. And he said to everyone, stop, don't eat. This sheep, this cooked sheep is telling me that it is poisoned. But Bishr has already ate from the sheep and died. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, ما زلت أجد من أكلتي الشاة في خيبر حتى قطعت الأبهر مني. I continued for the rest of my life to feel the pain of the poison of Khaybar until it cut my veins. Al-Imam Ibn Al-Qayyim says the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam died because of that. Because of the vein. He mentions, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, حتى قطعت الأبهر. الأبهر هو عرق القلب. The Prophet ﷺ says, this poison caused the vein of my heart to stop. Al-Imam Ibn Al-Qayyim says, the Prophet ﷺ died as a shaheed because he was poisoned in a battle. Yes, it took a few years later, but it is from that cause. It is the agreement of all scholars that if somebody is wounded in a battle and dies because of the wound 10 years later even, he's still a shaheed. Ibn al-Qayyim says to the Muslims, remember who killed your prophet. Never forget who killed your prophet. Anyway, so that was Khaybar, the 7th year of Hijrah. So many events detailed in As-Sirah An-Nabawiyyah. On the 8th year of Hijrah, Muslims were able to conquer Mecca in the great battle of Fath Mecca. Immediately after that, Hawazin, one of the strongest tribes, even stronger than Quraysh, decided to go into a battle with the Prophet, not to wait for him to attack At-Ta'if. Immediately, 2 months after Mecca, was the battle of At-Ta'if. And the battle of Hunayn with the people of At-Ta'if. And in the beginning of the battle, Muslims were defeated. وَيَوْمَ حُنَيْنَ إِذْ أَعْجَبَتْكُمْ كَثْرَتُكُمْ فَلَمْ تُغْنِ عَنْكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ شَيْئًا. At the battle of Hunayn, for the first time, Muslims were greater in number than their enemies. Muslims were 12,000, their enemies were 10. And they were defeated. Because they felt, we defeated the kuffar when we were few. Now we are more. Of course we will defeat them. You don't defeat them because you are more. And your army is stronger. You don't defeat them because of that. You defeat them because you are the army of Allah. You have faith and obedience. Only 100 men were left with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Only 100. And he continued to fight against the 10,000 of Hawazin. The news came to those who ran away that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is still fighting. He did not run away. So they started to come back. None of them reached Hunayn before the Muslims. Army of 100 defeated the kuffar army of 10,000. في الحديث, this is a hadith, والله ما وصل منا أحد إلا والمسلمون يجمعون الغنائم. This is the hadith. None of us arrived at the battleground until we saw the Muslims were collecting the spoils of war. Remember what is our balance. The year 9th of Hijrah, the Arabs came to Medina declaring their Islam. The year 10th of Hijrah, the Battle of Tabuk. For the first time now, the Muslim army led by Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is attacking the Roman Empire. It is not a message for the Arabs. It is a message for the world. Caesar heard about the army, and he heard that it is led by the Prophet. Caesar was a priest and a man who knows the holy books. He gathered his parliament and said, "Would you listen to my advice? They say you are our leader and our priest and the most knowledgeable among us. What is your advice?" He said, "Let us follow Islam because it will conquer the world." This man is the prophet that is mentioned in the books. They said, "No, we will not leave our religion." He said, "If not so, then listen to my second advice." They said, "Yes, what is it?" He said, "Don't face him in a battle. He will slaughter you, no matter how large your army is." They said, "With this we will listen." So the Roman army refused to meet the Muslim army. The Muslim army stayed in Tabuk for 1 month waiting for the Roman army to come. They did not. So, from the year 5, where we were so little, only in Medina, only 300, that's how large Islam was. I told you there was no civilization, no great buildings, etc. To the year 10, only 5 years, Muslims already have conquered Arabia and already are attacking the Romans who refuse to face them. Is that a gradual move or is that peaking so quickly? Look and think. And then in the beginning of the 11th year of Hijrah, the Prophet ﷺ died. And the Arabs turned away from Islam. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu insisted that he will fight them. Abu Umar ibn al-Khattab, the strong man, was hesitant. He said, "Oh, how could you face all of Arabia?" Only 3 cities were left as Muslims: Medina, Mecca, and the Taif. Mecca was thinking of turning away from Islam. Al-Taif was the last city to accept Islam in Arabia. So really they could not depend on anyone except Medina. That's all is left from Islam. Back to Medina. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq said, "I will fight them. Even if I'm alone, I will fight them." And he started to call any Muslim. There were many Muslims who still are Muslims, but as individuals all around Arabia. See, he called them to Medina. The moment he gathers a few hundred men, he will send them to fight one of the tribes. 12 armies